Hello, darling. Nice to see you.
It's been a long time. You're just as lovely as you used to be.
How's your new love? Are you happy?
Hope you're doing fine. Just to know it means so much to me.
What's that, darling? How am I doing?
Guess I'm doing all right, except I can't sleep and I cry all night till dawn. What I'm trying to say is I love you and I miss you, and I'm so sorry that I did you wrong.
Look up, darling, let me kiss you.
Okay, so your name is Scott.
Yep. Scott and, Benjamin.
All right, how long have you been doing taxidermy for?
13 years.
Okay, that's cool. Can you explain a little bit about the process of taxidermy?
Sure. Yep. Right. You want to kind of... We'll go from the beginning. When the animal comes in, it gets skinned.
Okay.
You take the hide off. Like behind you there, there's a coyote and a bear. The hide's taken off. Mm-hmm. And the hide's tanned. And you see all the toes and claws and ears are all still intact. All
right.
That's cool. The only part that we take from the animal.
Uh-huh.
And then... It's fleshed and tanned,
mm-hmm.
and turned into almost a garment tan, just like you would a fur coat.
Mm-hmm.
And then from that point, we take measurements,
mm-hmm.
and you can buy mannequins. Basically, just like the mannequins you see in department stores for people to try on clothes, you see in the windows of stores.
Mm-hmm.
Basically the same material. It's a polyurethane foam shaped like the animal's body.
Mm-hmm.
You see the deer there. Pull the face off the deer over here. There you can see all the muscle detail, veins, structural, skeletal.
Yeah.
Here, this one's in a a drying process where you
mm-hmm.
see a little bit of the clay around the eyes, we're filling in gaps.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the glass eye that goes in to the mannequin, and the hide is put over it and glued on and dried. Again, the hide is just like a leather coat.
Uh-huh.
So you're just basically skinning or gluing leather
uh-huh.
to the mannequin. The okay. ears are split inside and put in plastic liners.
Uh-huh.
And that goes in through the inside of the ear. This is a right hand ear. And it goes into the inside, between the inside and outside skin of the ear.
Okay.
That holds your ears in place. Mostly the tanning process, there's a variety of chemicals you can use.
Mm-hmm.
But you're pulling the moisture
mm-hmm.
out of the actual skin
mm-hmm.
and replacing it with a preservative.
Okay.
And then the skin remains kind of, most skins are very acidic and they get thick. So you
mm-hmm.
have to see how thick that is. It has to be thinned down so it's
yeah.
more
now,
like
now, do
a
you have to like comb the fur and stuff
yep,
like that?
Yep, it has to be shampooed and combed. Yep.
Cool.
It'll be put in a big sink back there and shampooed like your dog.
Uh-huh.
This is the Corsican ram. You see the actual, the hooves are still on it.
Mm-hmm.
Feet.
So you went to an art college. What kind of influence did that have on
probably
your taxidermy?
Wildlife art was my biggest influence all through high school.
Mm.
And then I went to Bryant Stratton Business Institute in Buffalo for commercial art. which is more geared towards advertising. Computers came along, took a lot of that away from the artist, and so I kind of steered towards taxidermy.
What's your favorite animal to taxidermy?
I would probably say for myself, a fish, because with my art background, I like to paint.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to use a lot of reference in painting and airbrushing. And yeah, this is all painted.
Oh, cool.
Largemouth bass.
Very cool. All right. What's like the weirdest animal that you've done, or some of the weirdest ones?
Probably the bat was pretty weird.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, because their skin is on their wings. It was kind of a challenge. Yep.
Yeah. So did somebody hunt a bat, and or
no,
did
the
they have like
had
a pet
to
bat
for the museum?
Oh okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Do people have pets done usually?
I get a lot of calls for pets.
Uh-huh.
I don't do a lot of pets. There's no market or vendors out there that sell domestic animal forms or materials to do pets. The big thing now is to have them freeze-dried.
Mm-hmm.
Most small animals can be freeze-dried, which is another extension of taxidermy, but I don't get involved with it.
Yeah.
They do the same process as freeze-drying flowers or plants.
Uh-huh.
But they just use the animals that way.
Huh. All right. What do you think drives people to want to own a piece of taxidermy?
I think as a hunter, you know, they spend a lot of time and money in the field, and they're looking for a way to continue the memory of the experience in the field. So they can take it home with them, put it on a wall or table, and every day be able to look at that and then remember the experience that they had out there.
Mm-hmm.
Photographs do the same thing, but basically taxidermy now has turned into more of a diorama kind of thing where, like you see in a museum, or they want an artwork kind of presentation so that it brings you outside, inside with the piece.
Hello, darling. Nice to see you. It's been a long time. You're just as lovely as you used to be. How's your new love? Are you happy? Hope you're doing